Welcome back to Nite Line. I'm telling you, this first hour is come and gone, and we're going back to Meghan Woods. She's going to do a couple songs, So Small and The Girl You Think I Am.
What you got if you ain't got love? The kind that you just wanna give away. It's okay to open up. Go ahead and let the light shine through. I know it's hard on a rainy day. You wanna shut the world out and just be left alone. But don't run out on your faith.
Sometimes that mountain you've been climbing.
Problem that seems so big at the time. It's like a river that's so wide, it swallows you whole. Now you're sitting around thinking about what you can't change, worrying about all the wrong things. Time's flying by, moving so fast. Better make it count, cause you can't get it back.
Sometimes that mountain you've been climbing, just a grain.
You think I'm strong, you think I'm fearless, All I want more than anything is to make you proud of me. 'Cause you think I'm strong. The girl you think I am.
Beautiful singing tonight, Meghan Woods. She's going to be joining us in a little while, her and Wade. And now's a good time. I'd love to hear some praise reports. Or if you've got a prayer request, we're going to be praying over them here in just a little while. The number is there at the bottom of your screen. Our prayer partners come so faithfully. We thank them so much, Monday through Friday. Why? Because they love you and they care for you, and so do we. We run into a lot of the people out and about that say, hey, we love Nite Line. They love Nite Line. They're so glad they're a part of the Nite Line family. Speaking of family, I want to introduce to you Megan's mom and dad, Eric and Jamie Woods. It's so good to have you here. This is somebody you hadn't seen that's kind of been behind the scenes, but I remember, Jamie, the first time seeing you at the fair. That's been many years ago when she was just 12.
I guess, yeah, 6 years ago now.
Yeah, it's been several years. 6 years, is that
right? I guess, six years.
And you coming up and saying, do you remember me? Of course, I didn't, because you were young then.
Right, right. And, well, it had been years since I had seen you.
I know.
So
I'm sure we both look different.
I didn't change much.
Lord.
Wade owes me money.
I know that. Uh-huh. I heard that. I know y'all are very proud.
We are.
Yeah, I know you have other children. How many children total do you have?
We have four.
Four children?
Yeah. We do. Megan's the youngest.
Yeah. Wow. Yep. Yeah, God has blessed you all so much.
Absolutely.
But Megan's journey, y'all been so faithful to be right there and just be supportive of her. Mm-hmm. What did you think when she wrote her first song when she was 11?
You know, I don't think we really knew what to think. Yeah. Honestly, we didn't know anything about this business or... and at the time, I think we thought, okay, maybe she can be whoever, but...
Like come to the fair.
Start realizing that it's not about her being like somebody else, it's her being her. Yeah. And we thought probably years ago that she was ready for this and that and the other, but not really. And now I'm starting to really appreciate the journey, because it has been a journey.
It's been a journey,
for sure.
But it's one that God's hands upon her.
Oh, yeah.
And it's so evident. She's bold with her witness. Mm-hmm. Some people would just hold it in, not say anything, but not her. Yeah. That's why God's going to use her. He already has.
Yeah, he has.
You know, certainly. And it's already made a difference. There's just no telling what all. I kind of feel like I'm on the journey with you. I hope you don't mind. But, you know, from day one when she sang at the fair, and then we got to come to the watch party, and we just kept up with her through the years and just seeing how she's matured, how she's grown in the Lord, the gifts, the 10 songs already the Lord's given her. Yeah. God's hands on her life, you know?
Yeah.
And when you were here last year, I said, did I hear word that you're going to have something like a wedding venue up where you live? And I said, come be on. You said, I'm not ready. I'm not ready. That was last year. But I knew it's been a journey, too.
It has.
Actually.
It has.
Hadn't it?
It's been about 2 years that we started building it.
Wow. I think we've got pictures, too, of all that tonight. We could just show our viewers, because this was kind of like, I don't know if it was a vision, a dream of how it came about, but there is the picture of, look at there.
Yeah.
Did y'all actually build that?
We did.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, wow.
We did, yeah.
Yeah,
so you knew exactly how you wanted it to look.
Yeah, right. We designed it and everything.
Oh.
Yeah.
Did you help her, Jamie?
Some days, yeah.
Some days. Okay, I got you.
He did the hard labor. Yeah.
And this picture here, how you captured that rainbow.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. That was just, that was amazing. And you knew on the property, how many acres do y'all have there?
We've got 22 acres. Yeah.
Exactly where you wanted to sit
in? Yeah. We did. So it had been something we had been thinking about for a while. Since our oldest daughter got married, we thought, well, maybe it's something we should do.
And her wedding, was her wedding?
Our second daughter.
Oh.
Her wedding was the very first wedding we had there.
And I think we've got pictures of that as well. But what a beautiful, beautiful location, building. I don't know. I want to come out. I'm going to come out and see all this. But there's the inside of it. I don't even know how it all came about. Did you just lay it out, or did the Lord help you with this, or?
You know, we actually started accumulating different things to go in it.
Okay. Is that the dressing room?
That's the groom room.
That's the groom room.
For the men.
Okay.
Yeah. And then there's a bridal suite.
Oh, that's a bridal
that's
suite?
That's a bridal suite,
So you thought of the groom as well.
Yeah, we did. Jamie's been tearing. That's my daughter's wedding. That was the first wedding that was
That
there.
Is so awesome. Look at that tree to the right of it.
Yeah.
That was a perfect place for a picture, wasn't it?
Yeah.
That was the first. And when was that?
That was in August,
two years ago. Yeah. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, she's almost been married for 2 years.
Wow.
So.
And so the name of it is Events at?
Events at Green Mountain Farm.
How did you come up with that name?
Well, our farm is Green Mountain Farm. Okay. That's our farm name. So we kind of thought about different names, but then we thought, no, that's our farm name, so we'll just stick with it.
So if you're looking for a place to have a beautiful wedding, this looks ideal to me.
Yeah.
It just, I don't know if you have any availability left this summer or not, or in the fall.
We do have some, yeah.
Okay.
We're already booking for 2020. So,
great.
Yeah.
We're also doing other events there as well.
We
actually are putting together a singing that'll be probably
it's a dinner show.
September, October dinner show.
Yeah.
And it's going to be fantastic.
Yeah.
That's something we need for the area.
Yeah. It's going to be fantastic.
Yeah. There's going to be three different artists there. Meghan is one of them.
Yeah.
And then the Carolina.
Okay.
And Chris Golden. His dad is one of the Oak Ridge boys.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And so,
and he is fantastic.
He's very good.
And so is that date in the late summer or fall?
It's going to be in the fall. Yeah. We don't have a specific date.
We haven't nailed it down yet. But
well, be sure and let us know. Well, Meghan is actually coming back in October. We've already talked about a different program for young ladies.
Oh, that'd be awesome.
And so maybe we can take that time to announce that as well. Maybe come back and just announce that.
Yeah.
Great.
So how many weddings do you think you've already had there?
We've had about seven.
Seven weddings.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah.
But you know what? So, it's good, too, to have other venues, like this special singing you're going to have coming up.
Yeah.
I think that's wonderful.
We do a farmer's market.
We have swing dance in there, which has been fun. That's been this summer. A group has been doing swing dance in there, which has been fun to
teaching
watch.
Teaching lessons and stuff.
That's great. Yeah.
So just different things.
Yeah.
And it gives you an opportunity. Now, are you still working?
I am, yes.
And you're feeling much better now. I know you went through a little bout with your health.
I did.
But you look great tonight.
Yeah, well, thank you.
That was a little bit of a journey for you, too, wasn't it?
It was, yes. It's a shock to your system.
Yeah. God's brought you through it.
Yeah, everything's
prayer.
Really good. Yes, ma'am.
That's a key right there,
isn't it? That's right.
To anything.
Yeah.
So what would you say to others that, I know, how many years, how long had you prayed and just seen that whole vision of this events center?
Oh,
I mean, that just didn't happen overnight.
No. It was probably three or four years,
maybe 5 years.
Before we even started.
Yeah. We had talked about it, and it's a little scary.
Yeah.
It's a step of faith, you know.
But isn't everything?
It is.
I mean, Meghan can just help back and not step right out into the gift wanted her, but she did, and even with that very first song, how it saved the life of that young man.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know?
Oh, I know.
To me, that's part of the journey.
Oh, yeah, it is.
You know?
You say if all this is just for that one person, then it's all been worth it.
Exactly.
You know? But I truly believe there's a lot more to that, you know? That wasn't just the only thing.
I know. But you're right. If it was just for that one person.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
And them thinking about doing, ending their life. Yeah. You know, and then I think about, too, at the watch party, I observe so many people coming in and so lovingly and supportive.
Yeah.
You know, I didn't know them, but it could have been family. It could have been friends. I knew family was there.
Yeah.
Because I know some of your family.
Sure.
But just the support. I mean, gosh. Yeah. How it just brought y'all so close to friends, family, probably coworkers. Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, and because, you know, the thing is, there are really dark days. Mm-hmm. There are days that are long.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes you're wondering, why in the world am I doing this?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so it's nice to have friends and family around you.
Yeah.
To makes a difference, encourage. Don't
it? Yeah. It really does. Yeah. Her journey has not been an easy journey.
No, it's not. I mean, there's a story to tell there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's been one day she can.
Hard journey.
Tell it all. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, and we've always said, as long as God keeps opening the doors, we're going to keep walking through them with her. So.
But you know how she got through the journey? She got through the journey, number one, with the Lord and knowing that He had control.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
Number two, she had supportive parents that said, hey, we're in here with you. You're not doing this by yourself. That makes a big difference.
Yeah.
Right.
I know that both of you. And I see both of you really just standing in there with her. Okay, whatever it is, we're here with you. Yeah. You're not by yourself.
Yeah. Right.
That had to make a big difference.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then her walk with the Lord, her stepping out and saying, okay, let's get together and let's pray.
Yeah.
Tell me that didn't. That had to have tremendous impact.
Yeah.
That had to.
Yeah.
You know.
Right. Yeah.
God certainly blessed everybody. I know y'all are just so proud of
her.
Well, we're talking about you. Are your ears burning?
They are.
That's what my mama used to say. She'd say, are your ears burning? I'm talking about you.
They are.
They're very proud of you, and so are we. Are we, Wade?
Absolutely. It's been a pleasure to follow your journey.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks.
And looking forward to, you know, what's ahead.
Thank you.
You know.
Thank you.
An excitement.
Absolutely, yes. Absolutely. Wade, you joined us over here, and I know you've got some praise reports. I see green papers, and tonight, I know it's been a different night. We've been talking about her journey, and I know it's probably touched a lot of young people tonight because she took some moments there just to minister to you, especially young people. But Wade's joined us here, and so I want you just to share some of those, and then we're going to take some time just for you tonight and pray over your needs and your requests. And your young people, I know there are things that are going on with young people. We're going to have a special program down the road in October, especially young girls. And so we just both feel impressed that it's time, you know, that we just really rally around our young girls and get behind them and pray for them and lift them up. And we're going to do that. We're going to talk about a lot of things that's going on that we feel like our audience needs to hear. So.
And I'm looking forward for this singing. You're putting together. I'd like to see that be so successful. You have to do it almost every other month.
Okay. I do too.
That would be so good.
Yeah.
You know, people do. People love good singing.
You know, when we grew up, we went to a lot of gospel singings. Emmanuel's did a lot of singing.
Lord, we followed y'all all over
the
country.
Oh, I'm telling you.
That's the truth.
And you know what we did that was different? We'd always bring a young group of young groups from churches, from youth choirs.
Right.
And I don't care if it was Mount Bethel or Hooper's Creek. And they would open up. And to this day, I still run into them. And they'll say, oh, my goodness, I remember you. And I don't remember. Do you remember me? And I was like, you did. I was like, no, not exactly. Yeah. What church were you? And they'd say, Mount Bethel or Hooper's Creek or Mount Sheba.
Right.
But they felt such a part. And that's just like you. They got that opportunity to sing and give testimonies. I remember one night at Hooper's Creek, the power went out. And I was like, okay, well, I guess we'll just go home. And those young people said, oh, no. They opened up the doors, every door they had, and the cars pulled up to the doors.
Oh.
And we still can sing it.
Oh, really?
That's
so, you know, where there's a will, there's a way.
That's right.
That's great memories.
That's always the best
moments.
The best moments.
And you know what? Sometimes it's the bad things you only remember, but then God takes those bad things.
Turns them around.
And our souls were saved that night.
That's right.
I remember the altars being filled.
It was awesome.
Awesome.
Talking about some good things here. A lady was legally blind, had trouble seeing TV for a long time. She's now beginning to see the TV clear. She's praising God for her vision coming back.
We rejoice with her tonight.
And here's one. A person had a blood clot in the heart, and was in a very serious condition, doing much better. Praising God for that.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Husband and wife went to a doctor. Both of them got great reports. Thanking the Lord for that. Husband, 58 years old, had a PET scan. The doctor came back and said they cannot find any cancer.
Thank the Lord. That's a great praise report.
And here's a mother had called in for a daughter several weeks ago, had an aneurysm. She went under surgery and is doing very good.
Amen.
Praise God for that.
Wade, won't you take some of those? We have about 3 minutes left, and let's just share some of the needs tonight and pray over them, and then Megan's going to close us out here in just a few minutes with a song. So let's just pass those down and
just take a few
give
there.
Give some to Erica and pass some to me, Erica.
Yeah, I'm going
to
let you guys have them. I don't have my glasses over. On.
Your needs are important to us here at Channel 16. We're concerned about your needs, and we know that God answers prayer. So tonight we want to share with someone that's just had sinus problem, and then here's another one that has back and leg problems, somebody that's got migraines. Maybe you could share one, Erica.
This is a lady has a pain in her neck going down her back.
Mm-hmm.
Prayers for family.
I got
friend's
one
sister
here,
passed
Gwen.
Away.
Stage 5 kidney cancer.
Jamie?
Grandson on drugs and needs salvation.
We need to really
that's
pray
a,
about this
that's
drug
a terrible
issue.
Thing, yeah.
Yes, yes. Erica?
Pain in chest and back.
Mm.
Friend Wendy, cancer is spreading.
Amen. Wade?
Here's one. Please pray for my daughter. She's going through depression, problems with alcohol, needs the Lord in her life.
Yeah.
Amen.
Maybe one more and then we'll go to prayer.
Husband needs prayer and he has a heart problem.
Okay. Amen.
Here's someone in a mental hospital and they're hoping that she could be released.
All right. Let's just go to prayer right now. You just lay your hands on your request there. And Father, we so humbly come to you right now. We know that you are a prayer answering God, a God that cannot fail, will not fail, that you always hear when we call upon you. You don't ever turn a deaf ear. You always make yourself available to us. And right now, Father, we lift up that one that's going through depression. We come against that spirit of depression and break it in the name of Jesus. And those that need healing in the back, in the shoulder, Lord, those that's just going through cancer, we just curse that cancer from the very root this night in the name of Jesus. And this one that's going through having to make a decision this night, Father God, we just thank you that you would give them the answer. Lord, show them the right way and things that they need to do. And Father, then we praise you for these praise reports. Those that have called upon you and have received, we thank you for that this night in Jesus' name. Lord, we don't ever come and ask anything of you that we don't say thank you and praise you. For you said in your word, I am the Lord God that healeth thee. And that it is by your stripes that we are healed and whole and well and we walk in health. And so this night, we just lay our hands on every request and just thank you that you're doing a work in every life this night. In Jesus' name, and it's done. It's done. It's done. Thank you all for coming, being our guests tonight. And from Wade and myself and our Nite Line family, we love you and appreciate you so much. Megan's going to close us out tonight with a song called Rainbow.
could see what I see, you'd be blinded by the colors, yellow, red, orange, and green, and at least a million others. So tie up the bow, take off your coat, and take a look around. Well, the sky is finally open, the rain and wind stop blowing, but you're stuck out in the same old storm again. So hold tight to your umbrella, 'cause darling, I'm just trying to tell you that there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head. Oh, tie up the bow, take off your coat, and take a look around. Everything is all right now, 'cause the sky is finally open, the rain and wind stopped blowing, but you're stuck out in the same old storm again. So let go of your umbrella, 'cause darling, I'm just trying to tell you that there's always been a there's always been a rainbow hanging over.